Hello and greetings from Iceland. It's time to talk about some of the things I've been noticing on the seismometers recently and the newly detected landrise on the Reykjanes Peninsula. But I am, however, starting today's journey with part 2 from a last thermal scan tour. And this is the location we will be looking at. It's a valley called the Móhálsadalur. It is a part of the Krýsuvík volcanic system and we are only around 10 kilometers away from Reykjavík. What we notice right away is this long but discontinuous fissure vent system that runs through the valley and makes it one of my favorite places on the peninsula. And I've mentioned it before, how strange it is that earthquakes have little by little been moving from the mountain Keilir, where the magma intrusion originated that fed the first three eruptions and actually further east all the way to the lake Kleifarvatn. And every now and then the seismometers are showing us some interesting forms there, often lining up along the deepest part of the lake where we find an old fissure. And sometimes we even see the earthquakes extend to the southwest and the northeast from the lake. So Mother Earth is definitely cooking something down there. And I'm not sure if it's going to be a good dish this time. Some of the biggest questions I came back with from this tour are about this ridge between the lake and the Móhálsadalur Valley. The ridge is called Sveifluháls and I did find a lot of heat signals there. But as always, it's difficult to distinguish between old and known geothermal areas and the new fumaroles that might be popping up. Like this area here, it's a known hotspot, just like this one. But I did find several other hotspots on the ridge that I would like to check better. And there is actually an online map that covers all areas with the surface heat in Iceland. And I'm leaving a link to it. But the accuracy could be better, so it isn't helping all the time. But the main problem is the radiation from the ground. All it takes is just a few minutes of sunlight and it becomes very hard to spot the contrasts that I'm looking for. And I want to thank those of you who have been sending me tips about this thermal scanning. I'm still learning and this is actually getting somewhere. And when it gets colder, the scanning will be so much simpler. And that is what I need. We have gone through 4 magma intrusions by Grindavík so far. And the seismic activity around the town is rising again. Then we got the news last week that magma has been confirmed at 16 kilometers depth under the peninsula and the land has started to rise again. There are still no INSAR images, satellite images available, but we should get them soon. And when we get more accurate information, we can start guessing again. Or where the next eruption will break through the Earth's crust. And as for the timing, as always, I'm getting different versions. At first, some of the experts suggested the first half of next year, but recently one of the experts said that the next eruption could take place as early as November this year. And since I'm not a scientist, it's very easy for me to take part in this guessing game. And I'm going to say now that all we need is one earthquake like magnitude 4+, and the earthquake plot will start to look like this, and the countdown timer is on. And after that, it could be as little as 2 weeks until the fire comes up. But that time, it keeps getting shorter, that we know for a fact. The ground is already very fractured around here, plenty of new channels already. So the main question for me now is, when could this earthquake occur that opens the way for the next eruption? And in order to answer that, I'm going to rewind to last February now to see how the last guessing game turned out. And I'm also linking to a video that I made back then where I was covering some offshore unrest on the westernmost part of the peninsula. And it was a research professor that stated back then that the next eruption could come up anytime. But the meteorological office back then said no, it's no way. It's going to be 1 or 2 more years that we will have to wait. But in fact, it was less than 5 months later when the next eruption occurred. So the professor got this pretty right. the peninsula was indeed ready. And the reason I'm mentioning this is that I think the peninsula is still ready. In fact, the seismic activity never dropped, like after the first two eruptions. Something big is cooking there, or widespread earthquakes. And we do also see offshore earthquakes every now and then, often followed with unrest near Grindavík. That supports the theory that there is a central volcano out there offshore that is pumping magma to the mainland. And if we are indeed moving toward the next eruption, let's hope it comes up in the same region as usual, but not around the town Grindavík or the Blue Lagoon. Grindavík was the main reason why I got the thermal drone, or during the magma intrusion in May 2022. So let's talk about my upcoming trip. It's a thermal drone tour first and foremost, and my main subject will be Grindavík and around the town. It's not because I believe that I will find anything this time. I actually doubt so, but I will get excellent comparison pictures to use if and when the situation becomes serious. I remember very well when one of our experts said in the media last year that if those inflation events keep on coming, something will give in at the end. And we could find ourselves in the same situation as in May last year, when all 3,300 townspeople were getting ready for an evacuation. But luckily, the eruption came up elsewhere. But the Grindavík dike was estimated to be around here, at the north side of Mount Thorbjörn, and reaching almost all the way to this enormous row of craters that have yet again been shaking recently. So let's rewind again to a recent video of mine, the first thermal drone video I made, and that video covered another giant crater row to the west of the town. It is called Eldvörp, and while I was making that video, I found this article at the Volcano Cafe website that somehow made sense, and it stated that the eruption responsible for those craters by town originated from a magma chamber in this offshore volcano that has been shaking ever since this chapter started on the Reykjanes Peninsula. So this article, it didn't come as a total surprise when I look at those time lapses I've been doing, covering earthquakes around there. And if it is in fact a dike, I have this question, or is it also responsible for the multiple inflation events around the mountain Thorbjörn, by the Blue Lagoon and Grindavík? And if so, how does it connect to the events on Faradalsfjall, where the three eruptions took place? But that may not be the main issue now, so let's stay focused to Grindavík. Icelandic scientists have positioned the dike around here, but during the inflation event last year, this Volcano Cafe author, who is a scientist, he wants to keep the possibility open that the dike is curving around the south side of Mount Thorbjörn, and if that is correct, it is not good news. I remember this when I noticed this curve on the seismometers just yesterday. But today, the earthquakes have moved a bit further west, and a whole lot of action. There would be a new inflation event around there. I would not be surprised. So, let's talk about the upcoming thermal scan. And I think you understand now why I need those comparison images that I will be getting. Because if there will be a new inflation event there, magma on the move, I will need those images to determine what is a new fumarole or not. We are on the plate boundaries, the land here is very fractured, so what I'm hoping is that we might see an indication before an eruption, something like steam or gases coming up from the fractures, perhaps some hours or even days before the actual eruption, or at least indicating what fissure form we should be avoiding. So this is simple, I'm just going after some before shots for the thermal drone. And since I have many new viewers now that haven't been following this from the beginning, I want to mention yet another video I made last year, shortly after the last magma intrusion by town, or the complete story about the Grindavík events, with lots of drone footage that explains the location of the town. And I am sure that the town would have been designed differently today. And as for other thermal scans I want to do, it will depend a bit on weather, and how long I can stay and such. But it's not cheap to travel in Iceland, as usual. I would also like to interview the local search and rescue team. They promised me an interview a while ago, and I just got a new microphone last week, suitable for the job. And I promised them also a demonstration with the thermal drone, because they don't have one, and I will for sure try to convince them to get one. The thermal drone was actually designed for search and rescue work, so it was actually quite surprising to hear how few of them are used here in Iceland. But at least I can say that I will prove them to be very useful. So this will be no ordinary tour. And as usual, there are links in the description, like how to buy me coffee on the road, to take part in my work, and feel free to visit my little local channel for some of the autumn colors that I shot last week, but they will be even stronger in a few days, and I have plenty of videos like this coming up here on my main channel soon, like videos from some of our largest volcanic systems that I look forward to show you. And with that, I'm sending you best regards from the volcano island, Iceland.